What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up your own Arc dedicated server using Pterodactyl. Now, if you haven't heard of Pterodactyl before, basically it's an application that makes running your game servers so much easier. You can give other people access, you quickly edit files, start, stop, update your server. You can do it all quickly through this nice web interface, and it's totally free. So I'll leave a link in the description and in the top right hand corner so you can install Pterodactyl on your server. It'll take probably 10 to 15 minutes for you to do. And then once you've done that, you'll end up at a screen just like this here. So this is a default dashboard. So we just need to click on settings. And if this is your first time setting up, we're going to have to allocate some ports. So we're going to click on nodes. Gonna click on whatever your node is that my last video would have taken you through this. Then we click on allocation. Then we put in the IP address of our server or the whatever your IP is. This has to be your external IP. And then the ports. So if we look here, I'll put this in the description. We need to open up, well, it says here we need to open four ports. We'll allocate four ports, so we're going to allocate 7777, so ports, let's add that, and then the next one, 7778, just paste that and click it, 27015, paste, click, and 27020, paste, and then we just click submit. And then as you can see, under allocation now, it'll show our IP address and it'll show you the four ports that we've just allocated to our server. So this is gonna allow the server instance to access these ports. So now we head over to servers. And then we click on create new. And then I'm just gonna call this Arc server. Server owner is Pedrotsky. Then we want to make sure it's on the main node or whatever your node is called, sorry. The default allocation, you can pretty much leave all of this. Actually, the default allocation, yeah, leave it as 7777 or 77. Then keep scrolling down, we can just leave all this as is. Memory and disk space need to be filled out. Basically, if this is your only server on the machine or game server, sorry, you can just set these to zero. This is just going to allow them unlimited access. Also, unlimited, it says here, allows unlimited memory and then unlimited disk space. Just set them to zero. It's more than fine to do that if it's just a small server. And then the nest configuration. This is so all we need to do is Arc is a source game. It's built in to Pterodactyl already. So we just click source engine. And then the first one should just be Arc Survival Evolved. Then we scroll down a bit more. There's a few other things that we need to do. Actually, it looks like we can leave all of this as default. So, well, obviously change the password. But yeah, you see here it's got the query port, Archon port. So, all right, we've done that. We click on Create Server. Now, all we need to do, we just need to wait for this to install. So if you go back to your dashboard, you're going to see it says like Arc server or whatever you called it. I'll just refresh that. It should show that it's installing. Yep. So here we go, installing. Then once this is done, we still have to allocate those ports to this server. So I'll just wait for this to install. And then once this is done, we'll come back and we'll go over the rest of the settings you need to change. Okay, so now the download's finished, you'll see the Arc server trying to start up. Basically, just stop it for now, and then click on this button right here next to settings. This is going to take us into the sort of more advanced settings. Then we need to click on build configuration. Then we need to go down here to allocation management, and then we need to hover over assign additional ports. So those, remember those ports we added to the node earlier? Well, now we've got to apply them to the game instance. So we can just add the other three ports now just by clicking on them. We can add them, and then we can click on update build configuration. So it says here that it's been saved. Now we can go back and start up our Arc server. Now, just a few words of warning as well. You do need to have a pretty powerful server for Arc. I think at minimum you need like 8 gigs of RAM. So it's kind of like Rust in the sense that it's just not going to boot at all if you're just running on the bare bones minimum server. And yeah, you'll see some of these like connection refused issues as well. Just wait for it. For the very first time, it's going to take quite a while to start up. So just let it do its thing for 10-15 minutes, and then all you need to do is go into game and then just copy this IP address here and then just add it to your favorites. So it's pretty simple, but if you get stuck, you can always come and join our Discord. We can help you out and help you get sorted. Or you can just leave a comment on my video if you get stuck. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. If you like the video or it's helpful, just give me a like and subscribe. And if you got any ideas for other videos, or you want to see me do like a specific tutorial on something, just again leave a comment, let me know. I always need ideas. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.